This is session two with a very important note on upgrading. If you're an existing user of Final Cut Pro 10, when you first run version 10.1, you're asked if you want to update. Click Update Later until you understand what the updating process does. All past events and projects must be updated before they can be accessed in the latest version of Final Cut Pro 10. Keep in mind that updating does not affect any media. For each connected hard disk or RAID that contains either a Final Cut Events or Final Cut Projects folder, Final Cut 10 creates a new library, names it after that hard disk, and moves those events and projects on that hard disk into it. This is really important. All existing events and projects on that hard drive are moved into a single new library. Any compound or multicam clips that are stored on other volumes and referenced by one of those events or projects are also copied into this new library. If you use project folders, any existing project folders are applied as keywords to the new converted projects. Media that is linked to an existing project or event is moved into an external media folder. To store all your media in a single location, you can always consolidate it later. Two more points on updating. Update All combines all events and projects stored on a single hard drive into one library per hard drive. Events and projects are still stored separately within that library. But this means that when you open that library into Final Cut, all those events and all those projects are open at the same time as you open the library. If you don't want these events and projects combined, then you need to manually update. Also, Final Cut does not copy media during an update. It moves the media. This means that no extra disk space is needed during an update. Only events stored in Final Cut Events and projects stored in Final Cut Projects are updated. However, the entire contents of these folders are updated at once. So, if you're manually updating, what you want to do prior to starting Final Cut 10 is to move only the projects you want to update into the appropriate folder. Then, start Final Cut 10 and click Update Later. When Final Cut 10 is running, select the appropriate hard disk and choose File, Update Projects and Events. Let me show you how to move and update events and projects manually. In order for earlier versions of Final Cut 10 to see an event, it needs to be stored inside the Final Cut Events folder. And I have an event here called JPUTCH, some media for a drama we'll be looking at later in this training. In order for Final Cut to see a project, it needs to be stored inside the Final Cut Projects folder. And here I have a project called Scene 1, Day for Night. If the files are stored anywhere else, earlier versions of Final Cut can't see it. So all the events that I don't want to have access to are stored inside a folder that I've called Final Cut Events Hidden. And these are all the events that I am not looking at this moment in time. So what I want to do is I want to update just specific events to put them into a specific library. For instance, maybe the events that relate to this drama, or a second library that contains events dealing with model railroading, and a third event that deals with snowboarding. If I put all of these events in the folder now, they all get put together into a single library. Instead, I will drag the projects that I want to update from wherever they're stored and only store those projects in the Final Cut Events library that I want to update. Okay, so I have these two here. I've got JPUTCH and I've got the Scene 1. If I wanted to have multiple events updated into the same library, then I would put multiple events inside Final Cut Events. If I don't want to have two events stored in the same library, then I'm going to do this in two passes. I'll put those that I want to update now in Final Cut Events and store the others somewhere else. Then when I'm ready to create the second library, I will create a new Final Cut Events folder. So let's switch over to Final Cut. Inside Final Cut, go to File, go down to Update Projects and Events. Update Projects and Events will update everything inside that Final Cut Events folder and everything inside that Final Cut Projects folder and put it into a brand new library. So I'm going to click Update All, and it updates all the files in that event and all the files in the project. Here, I recommend saying Save. don't move it to the trash. If it moves to the trash, it's not deleted. It's in the trash. If you need to pull it back, you can. But I'm going to say save. And there is my JPUTCH event. And there is my project. Well, where is it stored on the hard disk? Notice now the Final Cut Events folder is gone. Notice the Final Cut Projects folder is gone. If I want to update other events or other projects, I myself will need to create the Final Cut Events folder, and I myself will need to create the Final Cut Projects folder, and then drag those events into that folder. So do Final Cut Events. It's important to spell it right. Final Cut Projects. And now that I've created those, I would then go to my hidden folder, or wherever else the projects are stored, and drag the project that I want to update next so it's stored in the Final Cut Projects folder. Final Cut will only update projects stored in the Final Cut Projects folder. It will only update events stored in the Final Cut Events folder. Notice that my RAID is called Second Drive RAID. The library that it created is right here, Second Drive RAID. See that purple icon right there? That's the icon for the library. Let's just make this bigger. There we go. And these are the saved Final Cut Events folder. There's the original JPUTCH, and there's the original scene for one. And it's in its untouched state. This has not been modified at all. So if for any reason the update doesn't work, I can always go back into that saved version and rescue the project or rescue the event. If it's moved to the trash, you would do the same thing by opening the trash and being able to access the files by pulling them out of the trash. Updating works perfectly. What you need to decide is, do you want everything put into a single library for each hard drive, or do you want to have different libraries for different media and different projects? If everything goes into one, update all automatically. If you need to separate it, you need to update manually, and now you know how. Apple has published a white paper that covers this process in more detail. You can get it at www.apple.com/Final Cut Pro. Also, the folks at Intelligent Assistants have released a free version of Event Manager 10 along with a white paper, which can simplify the process of moving and updating older events and projects. Learn more at intelligentassistants.com. Updating isn't difficult, but you need to understand how the process works. To be safe, I recommend creating a backup of all events and projects before updating, just in case. Then update one event and one project and watch what happens. This is what I did when I was learning the system. Once you understand how this works, updating is simple. The key is to decide how you want your events and projects organized before you start the update process. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks.